Welcome, Raptor members. It's the Alpha and the Raptor, aka Alpha Dorsey, speaking here, and welcome back to Jurassic World again with another concept video of mine. Today, it is the Compsognathus, aka Compy, for in Jurassic World, the game inspired by Jurassic World Alive. But if we go to Isla Sorna, we do have a new VIP creature, and that is the Compy. Here we go. And here they are, my three little cute dinosaurs. There you go. Look at them as a new VIP creature. There we go. So I edited once again from Jurassic World Live to look like in Jurassic World the game. It looks pretty good if I do say so myself, and I think this could be a good idea for Lydia to add in this game. First off, looking at the designs, we actually have three compies in here, not just one. So we would have three little compies that we look at and showcase, as well as the feeding animation where they just all go to the meat and, you know, ravage it up and stuff like that. At the design, of course, the main one has that dark green color. As you see in the middle one, the main one, the alpha of the compies, I guess. And then on the side, we have the lighter skinned ones. Bit different patterns, of course, and when it's actually max level 40, all of them three will have different kind of max level 40 designs and colors, which would look amazing. Now, looking at their stats, you may be surprised at the stats I came up with this. You probably thought, hey, wait a minute, Gozzy, those are probably level 40 stats. No, these are purposely level 10 statistics, and let me explain. So, the level 10 compy that I thought of would have 2015 kind of health with 333 attack with around about 9,000 coin in 6 hours. Why so many health? Well, in Jurassic World Alive, of course, it is a creature that is in a group, as you see right here. So it has Hop and Mark and Alert Screw to recall another compy when it takes damage as a move, and it absorbs in three phases damage from the opponent. So it does not die in one hit. Now, how would that precisely work in Jurassic World game? Would you just keep it as a normal creature that takes normal damage and then doesn't do anything with the absorption features and stuff like that? Well, I thought it could actually work as a new dinosaur battling system species that you could just add for these special creatures, because you can add dinosaurs that are in groups. As we see right here, the compies. There's also the Cool Haste, which is an example that I just thought of right there. The other ones I'm not quite sure yet. Of course, you have Compsognathus Generation 2, but they work the same. Now, the stats, if it would work, and the MODs we actually have for the game right now, you can kind of survive with 1% health. That, for example, the Omega 09 has. It actually absorbs the damage and leaves you with 1, so you actually have 2 lives. Well, for the compies, we can still have 3. If it would work that way. And if it doesn't work out, we can always use the observe strategy that we actually have in Jurassic World Alive, kind of with the MOD battles in Jurassic World the game. We can select one to them and then kind of have it as the same as Jurassic World Alive. Now, let's say they would work normally, so there would be just the health and no other features to these dinosaurs, which would probably be the best case if they would add the compy. And that's where the health tank comes in. So then for a level 10 compy, you would have a lot of health, so it can kind of absorb a lot of damage, but does slight damage. So they would have a health tank, but you do minor damage to them, and when you have more attack points, it of course multiplies and builds up to eventually lead more damage. So let's say if you have a level 40 Compsognathus, you, for example, have 9,000 health or 12,000, just putting it out there, and then with example 1,000 attack. That sounds very little, or maybe 2,000. I don't know, when it goes through a VIP to stand against other dinosaurs such as me, the Indoraptor, I think that would be the kind of stats it would have to in order to make it usable. So that would be kind of the battle strategy. So it would have a lot of health and a little attack. But you can, of course, work with the reserves and stuff like that for your little compies. And for a special aid attack during battle, it can call in other compies just like the Velociraptor did in Jurassic Park Builder, where for the special attack it called other raptors and swarmed the opponent. That's what the compies can do in this game. So the compie would screech up and the other comps would swarm the opponent dinosaur, and that would be awesome. So that would be the end battle strategy. Now, looking at the petting animations, we have, of course, have a normal petting animation and an angry animation. I'll tap the compies right now. It's so cute when it does that little jump. And this is the angry animation. Yeah, I think that would be actually suitable for this game as well. Let's see the little jump again. Yeah, I love that final jump. It's like, whee! It's a little bit levitating there, defying gravity. Oh, well, you can actually with those legs, probably. Oh, they look so cute. Honestly, I would love to have compies in Jurassic World the game. Oh, that would be so amazing. Let me know what you think of my idea down below. Let me know what you think of this edit right here. Okay, before we get into the MOD battles I want to do for today, of course, we have an unfinished hybrid that we need to create, and that is the Dilophobia from the last episode. Here it is, level 31. Look at that. Oh, it looks like it could eat all the compies. Whoa, yo, look at this. I hope you're better in here than in Jurassic World Alive. Alright, here we go. Let's feed you to level 40. There it is. Oh, look at that poor little dodo. And it is gone. Look at that. Looks like a dragon without wings. Reached its maximum level. Then at 11,000, almost 12,000 health, like I said for the compy, with 3,000 attack and 571 with almost 1 million coin in 12 hours. So let's read these. Don't let this hybrid near the thermostat. What? Its preferred temperature is approximately 90 Fahrenheit. Okay. The Titanoboa likes to prey on aquatic creatures. On megalodons? While Dilophobia hunts mainly on land, so Titanoboa just squeezes a megalodon. Dilophobia is a venomous constrictor. Ah, yes, when is the Spino Constrictor coming? Oh my word, looking at the stats for this one, what the Spino Constrictor be? Looking at the design, look at those spikes on top right here. That looks great. Let's see the angry animation for this one. I can't even see it. Oh, there it is. It is too massive. Okay, let's use you actually in battle. Let's use a Bumpy as the first creature. Then we'll move in with the Dilophobia and then an Indoraptor Generation 2. So this is probably the Observe one from Jurassic World. It kind of works similar. For Dilophobia, we need Toxin. That suits it very much, doesn't it? Damage from first attack received to reduce by... Okay, yeah, let's do that one. So this snake can actually fight against Indoraptors and a level 31 Dilophobia as well. Let the battle begin. If only we had compies for this. So here we go. Alright, you immediately swap into a different creature. The first attack, we will not lose any damage. Let's go for more reserves here. So these MODs will come later for these dinosaurs. We actually have a level 31 Dilophobia with an armor matter. I don't even have you, but I do have a Bumpy though, so that's good. One, I got, here we go, yes! So armored hide gets activated. 31 damage. Okay, I think we need to switch in into Indoraptor. Right there, you get the advantage. So yeah, you're gonna get knocked out. Let's see, one, two, that does it already. I don't know how much it said to be there for one block. Let's go into and one reserve. We do have the survival one. Wait for one block. Tough skin, what does that do? Does it help? No. Oh no. Ooh, here comes Dilophobia. That is an actual threat now. Look at this. Oh wow, it looks awesome. Alright, three. Oh, we can actually increase health. Oh, okay. Well, thank you for switching out there. Couldn't see what it did. Oh, you blocked one. Okay. You can have it. And what is this? This kind of works as the Observer now. From it's a compy in disguise. It's a compy with wings. Three, but I got compy powers. Right there. Yes, you can knock me out with a Fallout 4. There it is. Ooh, a quick snap. And mine comes in with the toxin. We didn't actually need the toxin because I'm about to wreck this snake. Give me my compies back. I can still hear them. Compies. In the snake body. Give me back the compies. 71,000 damage. Let's see. Here we go. Special attack. And there it is. How does one snake strangle another snake? Let's see once more. I can't stop looking at it. It's just so cute. Look at that. I want to have it for breakfast. I mean, pet it. Yes, hold it. That's what I wanted to say. Yeah. All right. So, yeah, let me know what you think of my compy idea for this game down below. And make sure to, of course, stick around for more dinosaur goodness. With that being said, I hope all of you lovely compies are going to have a great dinner. See all you lovely raptor members in the next Jurassic World game episode. Goodbye, compies. Alpha Indoraptor out.